Welcome to Mastercrafts. Tonight we're going to meet Florence Hurewitz, a professional painter from Fairlawn whose work has been displayed across the country. Mrs. Hurewitz holds a degree from the Cooper Union School of Art and Architecture, and she's been displaying her work since 1966. She's been the recipient of many awards and honors, and on tonight's program, she'll share some of her work with us.
I always drew. The high spots in my childhood revolve around drawing. And I remember drawing, realizing that when you draw, it's supposed to look like people. It was a big revelation to me. I didn't even feel particularly proud of it. I just took it for granted, like the fact that I had black hair, I was left-handed, I could draw. I remember being worried once because there was a boy in high school who could draw well. But it was, I had to satisfy myself. I really just did not expect my own contemporaries to draw as well as I did, not while I was growing up. I had heard of Cooper Union. I heard it was 4 years of free tuition. It was a great school. And that's what I wanted to do. My contemporaries were way ahead of me, certainly in their knowledge of what was expected of them and in the language of art. Now, I just didn't understand what my teachers were talking about, but I loved it. and it took a while. It took a while. I did get to understand, but it took me quite a while. The fact is that art the knowledge of art comes through experience, and you can't learn it fast. But we did have all the chances and the kind of people who could set an atmosphere where you could learn. Style is something which is part of your training. You learn about style through the history of art, like going to the museum and seeing Picasso, who's a cubist, or the Impressionists, that style. You begin to learn from these people. And you think, you sort of do it intuitively, but in other words, you allow yourself to be taught and impressed by the people you respond to. I always work directly from life. I never work from a photograph because it's kind of boring. When you work from a photograph or even a grid, which is a way of enlarging a drawing, you lose the excitement, the emotion. It becomes measuring. This was 66, and for me an important year because it was the first time I became part of a gallery. I was kind of worried about entering because I'd hate to have been rejected. I was still working then in post-impressionist color, but using the figure. But what was happening is that because I was doing a lot of studying before my lectures in modern painting, I became more aware of what my influences were, and became aware of the fact that I was very much impressed with some of the things that happened when I looked at abstract expressionism, particularly Franz Klein. It was American, I liked the scale of it, I liked the color, and so I felt, and so my painting did change right then. This is called Beatrice, and it was the beginning of working with a different kind of color and scale, influenced by the American use of color, the abstract expressionist, particularly Franz Klein, use of black and white, larger scale, and it's an important painting for me because it's the first time I won a prize. The double Eiffel was done a little bit differently in that instead of drawing directly, I took two small drawings and I blew them up on the canvas with the projector. I liked the sketches. They had been done from life. They're not photographs. In fact, there's a lot of exaggeration, which I probably wouldn't have done if I worked directly on the canvas. The double Eiffel won my best prize, I think, because it was the first prize in a national show at the National Academy. What's happened now is that I've begun to work, well, I call it my confrontation series. It started when one of my models came and just plumped herself down on a high stool and looked directly into my face, into my eyes. And it was the first time I had seen someone pose that way, completely interested in what I was doing. And I found I was working larger than life, and that it was kind of exciting, with kind of a departure from the inwardness of all my reclining subjects. Margie did the same thing. Margie's a very direct person. She's a choreographer. She's got a lot of ideals and gumption, and I think that's what I was attracted to in Margie. Gail is a continuation of the confrontation series. The scale was just getting larger. I was trying to work without shadows, something which I've begun to question now, because the feeling of seeing large images with many lights in the media. Whenever I do a self-portrait, it's because I've hit a snag in my painting that I want to work out. For instance, there was a minimal use of shadow in the other paintings. It was almost an exclusion of shadow. Here I'm not afraid of it. I'm sort of including it and working in under a direct light, a light from above. In doing the large scale direct faces, I found that I was possibly being less realistic than I wanted to be. I wanted not to look pleasing particularly. That was part of it too. To be honest, I think there's a tendency to prettify yourself, to idealize yourself. I was trying to be objective. The part of painting seems to be change. Actually, you explore an idea until it has no more mysteries for you, and somehow that brings on new ideas, and so you're always moving to a different area, and you don't want to go back. I think you paint as long as you feel the excitement. When it becomes medicine, you better go someplace and try another one. You have to believe in it, and you have to have the excitement to